If you're watching this video, you probably realize that learning new software can be quite challenging. So in this video, I have come up with the top 5 beginner mistakes that students make with After Effects and how to fix them. If that sounds interesting, let's get started. One of the most common beginner mistakes with After Effects is double-clicking layers. Now, double-clicking a layer in After Effects actually brings up a pretty useful feature, but only if you intend to use that feature. But what I find is a lot of students would double-click a layer and then not understand why they can't access the comp anymore. So let's go and have a look at this comp that I have open. So here we have a plane scene. These are a bunch of different passes that have been composited from Maya. And if we were to double click, let's say, on this AO layer, the first thing that students start to do is maybe they're wanting to change the color correction. And they'll start changing a curves or something. And then they'll say, it's not working. I can't see it or whatever. And that's because you're looking at a layer. So double clicking a layer opens up a layer view. Now by default, the layer view will cover up whatever other composition or other view that you're looking at appear. So two things that make this very, very clear is this bar at the bottom. So this is a great way if you're looking at a sequence, you can quickly just look through different parts of it, which is great. And you can also look at different effects, but most of the time I find that students don't actually want to do this and they didn't really mean to double click on the layer at all. So in this case, what you can do if you want to see the layer and you also want to see your composition, you can always drag your layer off to the side and have a look at that one layer. And then you can see the composited result on the left hand side or wherever you decide to place this. But more commonly, all you need to do is simply click the little X or simply click back on composition. Now there is another feature that I think is pretty useful and I wanted to just make sure everyone is understanding it. So let's double click that again. When you're looking at a layer that already has effects on it, for example, this is supposed to be just an AO pass and we don't really want to see the entire beauty shot that's being rendered out. So if you go down to view, you can decide to view nothing, so just the source itself. You can do it with masks on it, or you can choose specific layers to view. So for example, here I can look at the extractor, which has extracted out the ambient occlusion pass. So we're just looking at this. Or we could even go and use a set matte effect, so we're getting rid of the background there. Or we could also show it with color correction on as well. So this is a pretty useful feature as well. All right, so moving on to the next one is accidentally clicking caps lock. So caps lock actually has a pretty useful feature, and that feature is if you are going to be making a lot of changes, let's say a camera lens blur, for example, on multiple layers, camera lens blur is quite an intensive effect. It takes a long time to process. So you might hit caps lock, make your changes, and it's going to be able to update the values pretty quickly, and it's not going to try to render them on the screen. But what a lot of students do, they might be trying to hold down shift, but they accidentally click caps lock. And if you move ahead in the timeline, they'll say, oh no, it's broken. My render's black, why? Just look for this refresh disabled button. It even tells you caps lock is what you should click. It's a very useful feature, but again, it's something that a lot of beginners click on by mistake and don't realize what they've done. Another really common mistake is to accidentally mess up the UI and not know how to fix it. For example, you could be moving some panels around or by accident simply click the X and your viewport, for example, goes away. Or it could be any of these other panels. If you remember the name of the panel, the easiest way to fix it is to go up to Window and then go and select the name. For example, this one was Composition. I can select that and everything is reset. If you do something a little bit more severe, like you take your timeline view and accidentally move it up here, for example, or take your project window, move it down here, and you just want to reset the view, the easiest way is to go back up to this menu and click Reset to Save Layout. And this will go back to whatever it was before you started making changes to what was saved. However, if you have already moved some windows around and you haven't resaved that layout, you will lose any of your customization and you will have to go and re-add them. Another thing you can do is click these two little arrows up here and select all panels, and all panels will make sure that you have everything that you need to see on the window. However, you can also change these, so the easiest way is to take a workspace that you're happy with and simply save the workspace. I found that masks are another thing that at least students find pretty difficult to get started with. So when you're using masks in After Effects and you click up here on the pen tool or the shape tool, if you don't have anything else selected and you just start clicking, you might not realize it, but until you start moving this spline around and so you can get a good fill like this, you're actually creating a shape instead of a mask. Now shapes and masks do share a lot in common, but they also share more differences. So shapes, I would recommend not to be used for roto masks. They are very useful, but just not for this. So make sure that when you are trying to rotoscope, you need to have another layer. Preferably, you want to have a solid selected, but don't just click out in the open. So what I would do, just delete this. You want to make a new solid, right click, new solid, turn the solid off, and then do your roto there. Likewise, if you're trying to select a roto mask, what you want to do is click M on the keyboard to access all your available masks. In this case, if we're only looking at one here, all you have to do is select one of them, and then you can marquee select the rest, like that. If you already have them all selected, or if you instead selected the mask, everything will select. And if you want to select just a single vertex or just a collection of vertices, you need to click off once to the side, then select one of the vertices, and then you can select the rest. You can also do the same thing by holding down the shift key and selecting individual vertices as you go. So the last thing I wanted to show you is something that's a little bit more tricky to understand, and it gave me a pretty hard time when I was learning After Effects. And that is the difference between duplicating a comp in the comp window down here versus the project window up here. And there is a very distinctive difference between the two methods. So for example, let's say we wanted to take this inner part of this wound and drag a copy over here and then make some changes to it. What you might think to do is to go to that composition, do Control D to duplicate it. In this case, I'm going to turn off the track mat. I'm simply going to move this over. I can even change transform information. I could rotate it and everything's fine so far. So let's say I wanted to make some changes to the effect inside this composition because it contains multiple layers. So I'm going to lock this composition so we can see what happens on the outside. And then I'm going to double click this infection comp to move this over. So now we're working inside this infection comp, but we can see the main comp over here. What we have just done, instead of making a true copy, we have made an instance. So in a lot of design software, an instance is a copy, but when changed, will change all of its copies automatically. And it's a very useful feature to have, but in After Effects, it's kind of unclear how this is set up at the beginning. So what we've done here is made an instance. So we might come in and then try to change, let's say, this texture. So I'm gonna select this texture. You just move around this mask. You might notice is it's changing both places. So as I make changes here, it's changing here and it's changing here. If I were to simply hide that layer altogether, it hides in both comps. So if I were to even do something like take this pre-comp, maybe turn off the turbulent displacement, it turns it off on both of them. So this is a very useful feature to have, but not in this circumstance. So let's go back to the main comp here and just reset those changes. So what you wanted to do here is make a true copy. And the way you do that is you need to go and copy it inside the project window. So if you don't know what the name of this is, or maybe you changed it, you can right click, go to reveal, and then say reveal layer and source project, which is named something a little bit different. But if you were to select this layer and then make a duplicate, so Control D, you have now a completely separate composition that has a different name. Then all we have to do, make a duplicate down here as well, so it maintains the same connections and transforms, hold down Alt, and then click over the copy, and what you have done is you've transferred this one on top of this one. If I click back to source name, this says nastiness, this is nastiness 2. I'm going to turn the track mat off here, move this back over to the side. And now I can make whatever changes I want, and it's only going to affect the new copy, not the original.
Alright guys, thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys learned something. If you did, drop a like. If you have any questions or you think I missed something, post a comment. And I'll be back very soon with another video. Peace.